Thank you, everybody, for coming to the Aaron Torres Podcast YouTube page. I do have one quick favor before we get to the video that you came here for, and that is very simply this. You see that little red subscribe button below this video? Go ahead, smash that subscribe button. It really does help me. It really does help this channel grow and my audience grow. So go ahead and hit that red subscribe button. And now, here is the video that you came here for. But with that said, let's get into the topic of the day in college sports. I think really across all of college sports. And really, it is the annual time where we just discuss John Calipari and NBA coaching rumors, right? Like this has now become an annual tradition, like the Victoria's Secret fashion show, like the leaves changing in the fall, like you yelling at your grandparents on Thanksgiving Day. Whatever you consider to be an annual tradition, John Calipari getting thrown into NBA coaching rumors happens pretty much every year. It happened on Wednesday. And of course, we also immediately got the rebuttal from John Calipari saying he has the best job in the world. And so because of it, talk about two things that happen simultaneously. We get the Calipari rumors. We immediately get the rebuttal. And so what I want to do is I want to spend the next few minutes not really talking about the rumors themselves, since John Calipari has already said that he is, you know, he has the best job in the world at Kentucky, but really just the idea of, has the window closed on Calipari going to the NBA, or is it still open? Because I actually believe the window, for a couple different reasons, may be more open now than it was even a year or two ago. So let's get into it. And the story really was actually pretty simple. It wasn't that big of a deal, but because Kentucky is the biggest program in college basketball, in my opinion, certainly the most covered, there's probably more interest in Kentucky basketball than anywhere else. The rumor picked up steam really quick, and it basically came from a Yahoo report on Wednesday that was basically just listing all the different candidates that could be potentially the next in line to get NBA head coaching jobs. And the NBA coaching carousel is currently underway. As best I can tell, I believe 6 jobs are open. I talked a little bit about Penny Hardaway the other day and maybe a potential interest between him and the Orlando Magic, but 6 jobs are opened up, and Yahoo just listed 10 people that they believe are candidates for some of these marquee jobs. Names you probably have thought of: Jason Kidd, former NBA player, Lakers assistant coach; Becky Hammon, longtime Spurs assistant coach, likely will become the first female ever to coach a major professional sports team on the male side. The typical names that you would expect. And then, of course, there is John Calipari. And I'm going to just try to be brief, but here is what Yahoo said about John Calipari's prospective NBA coaching opportunities, as he is listed by Yahoo Sports as one of 10 potential candidates to become an NBA head coach this offseason. This is what Yahoo said. Calipari is a bit of a surprise here, but multiple sources tell Yahoo Sports Calipari would be open to jumping back into the NBA. He had a taste of it in the late 90s, taking over the then New Jersey Nets following a stint at UMass that didn't go particularly well. But the changing dynamics at Kentucky, along with the massive expectations from the fan base and alumni, could have him looking for a second bite. He may have maxed out at Kentucky, a high-ranking executive told Yahoo Sports. College basketball is a sinking ship, another executive said. He is much different now than his first go around, but that ego is hard to tame. And then they talk about a few different things, blah, 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 blah. But essentially, Yahoo has listed John Calipari at 62 years old as one of the biggest names in the NBA coaching carousel. And as I said a minute ago, John Calipari, within hours, immediately shot down that report. And what he said is, it's that time of year. Why do rumors always start when we're in the middle of recruiting? I have the best job in the country with the best opportunity to impact young people and add value to their careers, and that has not changed. This season can't come fast enough. Let's go. So, if you were worried in that, I don't know, 90-minute window about John Calipari probably leaving, you don't have to be worried anymore, as he officially shot it down. And what I would say about just the Calipari NBA stuff in general, one, I would say, there are times when the Calipari NBA rumors have been legit. I think everybody kind of knows, but kind of going into the 2014-2015 season, Cal, I believe, seriously considered leaving, but that was the year he had a million returnees, probably his most talented team ever, and he decided to stay. And so, look, the rumors at times have been legit. I would also say I think there have been other times where John Calipari and his camp and his group, his agents, whatever, whatever have maybe put his name out there because they want his name to be out there, maybe to let the Kentucky administration know, hey, I have other options. Let that Kentucky fan base who is passionate and loves college basketball, and I don't blame you guys one bit because you allow me to do what I do, Kentucky fans, maybe let them know, hey, I have other options too. So what I would say pretty simply is I think there have been times where Calipari has both seriously considered going to the NBA, and I think there's also been other times where maybe he hasn't been considering it, but he either wanted a raise or he wanted to prove a point or he wanted to send a message to his bosses and basically put out those rumors. Now, this time, I do not believe this time that Calipari or his camp was behind it. Because first of all, just listen. First of all, the most basic thing is this, is that one, I don't believe that John Calipari would spend the entire offseason revamping his roster, changing how they're going to play, changing who they are, bringing in a bunch of new personnel, selling kids like CJ Frederick, Kellen Grady, Oscar Tshiebwe, all these guys that have come into the program. I don't believe that he would do that if he was deciding to leave college basketball or seriously considering it. I would also say I don't think he revamps his coaching staff, bringing in Orlando Antigua, one of his best friends and most trusted confidants in college basketball, if he was planning on leaving, right? Like, because the thing is, like, yeah, maybe 5 years down the road, or 3 years, if let's say something crazy happens and Kentucky wins two more national championships, then maybe he retires, he hands it over to Orlando Antigua. But obviously, when you bring in a new guy, even if he has ties to Kentucky, it's not as though Orlando Antigua would get the job if he left. And so Calipari is not leaving this offseason. You don't revamp the roster, bring in one of your most trusted confidants, bring in Chin Coleman, another rising assistant coach, if you're not going to be around. And then two, I would also say, like I said, these rumors did not come from him, because listen to the quotes. The quote was, he may have maxed out at Kentucky. You can say a lot of things about John Calipari, but I know for a fact that John Calipari doesn't think he's maxed out at Kentucky. I think that he's really excited about this coming season and that this next season has a chance to potentially be special. So because of it, I don't really want to spend a ton of time on like the, do you believe what he tweeted? Yes, I believe that he is not a candidate for NBA head coaching jobs right now. But I do think kind of the interesting question is, would he ever consider actually leaving for the NBA? What would it look like? What kind of circumstances? Because I will be honest, I believe that now, more than maybe a year or two ago, remember, he signed that quote-unquote lifetime contract after whatever it was, the 2019 season, I guess it was, when UCLA came calling. I believe it's more likely now than maybe it was 2 years ago. And so the question becomes, would he ever leave? And I think there's a few factors to consider. One, I do think you have to consider things did not go well last year. And if they don't go well again next year, I mean, I think he's got to at least consider an escape plan, right? Now, for the record, let me just be abundantly clear. I actually think Kentucky's going to be really good next year. I think you factor in the weird offseason, the fact that the players couldn't practice, couldn't work out, whatever. They had a young team. They had a bunch of freshmen, maybe a little bit of entitlement. There were no veterans, one returning player who couldn't play. Basically, everything that could go wrong did. Kentucky goes 9-16. For the record, I actually think Kentucky's going to be pretty good this year, and I'm actually really excited to see them play. But listen, let's also call a spade a spade. If Calipari has another year like he did last year, he's going to be looking for a way out the side door. And obviously at that point, the only justification you can have is the NBA, is the possibility of leaving for the professional ranks. And so I do think it's possible. I don't think Kentucky's going to be bad, but if he has lost his fastball, if he is not competing at the highest level for those SEC championships, for those Final Fours, for potential national championships, then I do think, yeah, like he is going to consider other alternatives. And let's be honest, Kentucky fans are going to want him to consider other alternatives. Again, I mentioned it. The number one state that downloads this show is the state of Kentucky. I know you guys, I appreciate what you guys do, and I appreciate the support that you give me, and I know how much you love Kentucky basketball, and the one thing you can definitively say about Kentucky, I give Kentucky fans credit for this. I have always said that Kentucky basketball is covered. They're the only college basketball program in America that is covered like a college football program, and what I mean by that is this. Kentucky basketball, if you lose one game, it is the end of the world, and guys like Matt Jones on Kentucky Sports Radio, myself, I mean, I don't get the volume that Matt does, but Matt's going to get calls all day, every day, until Kentucky figures out what's wrong and gets it right. Other college basketball programs, I mean, even, you know, UNC, it has the Charlotte Hornets, the Carolina Panthers right in their own backyard. Kansas has the Chiefs. So it's not the day-to-day, minute-to-minute that being the head coach of Kentucky is, or being in that Kentucky community is. And so because of it, it is not an easy place to coach. I think Calipari has done about as great of a job as ever. But again, if he has the type of season that he did last year, like this isn't, you know, what's going on at Syracuse where Jim Boeheim is an icon and he gets 5, 6, 7 years in a row where they're kind of good but not great. Like, no. Kentucky is its own beast, and so obviously the possibility exists that, like, if he's just not good, he really might look for an escape hatch. I think the other thing that we have to at least consider in terms of what the next 4 or 5 years look like, not only with Kentucky basketball, but with Calipari, is what I've talked about so many times, is this name, image, likeness stuff. And I'm not going to go down the deep rabbit hole that I've done time and time again. I did it with Roy Williams. I did it with Coach K. I'm not going to do it again. But this landscape is changing so fast and so furious. And I know some of you have commented. I got a great comment in the iTunes reviews. One of you reached out and said, "Hey man, look, I bust my butt. I work 10, 12 hours a day. I don't get paid $8, $10, $12 million a year to be a coach. I have no sympathy for these guys if they are complaining about the job and the responsibilities that come with it." And so to be clear, I totally get it. All I am saying is that the way that college basketball and college football have been done forever is changing rapidly, and I do think some of these guys that have options are going to seriously consider them. Now, what I would also say is a couple things. One, as long as college basketball is played, somebody is going to want to coach at Kentucky. No different than somebody's going to want to coach at Duke, coach at North Carolina, coach at Michigan, coach at Michigan State, coach at UCLA, coach at Arizona, coach wherever. As long as college basketball is played, somebody is going to want that Kentucky job. I also would say that in terms of Calipari, I think he is more in that Nick Saban where I do believe this is his last job. I don't, you know, Nick Saban, I think if Nick Saban was 40, I think he would seriously consider the NFL and say, do I really want to be part of college football as it evolves over the next 10 or 15 years? And Coach K even said that when he retired, was like, yeah, if I was 50 and I got offered the Lakers job like I did when I was actually 50, if I was 50 now and offered it, I would seriously consider it. I think Calipari's kind of in that age range where I do believe that Kentucky is going to be his last job. Same with Jay Wright, same with Nick Saban, same with guys like that. But as I've told you time and time again, as these sports continue to evolve, I do think some of the younger guys that have legitimate options, I do think are going to look at the professional ranks. Maybe not John Calipari, but maybe a Lincoln Riley at Oklahoma. Maybe a Ryan Day, the football coach at Ohio State. Maybe even a Chris Beard, who's in his mid to late 40s, who might have an opportunity to coach in the NBA. Tony Bennett, in his early 50s, might have a chance to coach in the NBA, because college basketball and the reason that these guys got in it is completely changing. Let's just be honest. Let's call a spade a spade. Let's be honest. Things are changing really quickly, where less and less it's about, one, the product on the court, but two, the actual coaching of basketball. As I've told you before, with name, image, likeness coming in, you are now going to have agents sitting in the room during recruiting meetings saying, what can you do for me? Like, it's great that you have this education and the history program and the comms department, and I'm glad that your biology department is number one in the country, but what can you do for me? I saw you get this guy this last year. Can you do that for me? On top of that, you have essentially free agency in college sports, where a kid is unhappy, he has a bad day, he has a bad week, he has a bad month, and he says, you know what, screw it, I'm out of here. And so I believe that is a big reason why Coach K left. I believe it's a big reason why Roy Williams left. And I believe it's a big reason why coaches that have real options are going to consider other alternatives. For the older guys, maybe it is an earlier retirement. Maybe Coach K, or really Roy Williams, did get out 2 or 3 years earlier than he wanted just because he didn't want to deal with all of the changes and what does it mean. I also think for the Ryan Days and Lincoln Rileys and Chris Beards, maybe that means going to the professional ranks. Because as I told you a minute ago, if you're going to be dealing with agents, and I've coaches have told me this, by the way, if you're going to be dealing with agents and you're going to be dealing with essentially free agency in college sports, I think there's a lot of coaches that say, well, I'll just go to the pros where all I have to do is coach and the GM takes care of it. The GM is the one that negotiates contracts and deals and this and that. The GM is the guy that signs free agents. The GM is the guy that drafts guys. And I'll say, you know, and in college, I'm not going to have to deal with that anymore, and I don't want to deal with that. I want to go back to just coaching, just talking about the biology department, just recruiting, all that good stuff. So I do think it's possible that if name, image, likeness goes off the rails really quick and it becomes the wild, wild west, and for the record, the NCAA doesn't step up and put in guidelines, that a guy like Calipari maybe in 2 years would seriously consider going. I mean, if this transfer thing doesn't work, he has a bunch of transfers in his program right now. If it doesn't work and he says, wait a second, I brought in these guys and it didn't work, and the high school guys, and maybe he gets burned by a couple of these G League kids that he recruits, and at the last minute they decide to go pro. Like, I could see this scenario where at 63, 64, 65, he says that he is going to go pro. On the inverse, I should mention the opposite could be true too. I had a Kentucky fan bring this up to me, which I thought was really interesting. As of right now, name, image, likeness, there is no set uniform rules. Why is that important? It is important for one simple reason. It is because right now, the biggest fear in the quote-unquote name, image, likeness game is that every state is going to have different bylaws and say Alabama can do things for college athletes in the name, image, likeness world that Kentucky can't, or that Tennessee can't, or that Arkansas can't, or that California can't, or that Michigan can't. Ohio State fans worried about what Michigan can do. Michigan fans worried about what Ohio State can do. And so I only bring that up because that could be another reason to push Calipari away. He says he has the best job in the country. I believe that he believes he has the best job in the country. But what happens if Alabama or Tennessee or the North Carolina schools can do more for their players and he is no longer on a balanced playing field? I don't think that's going to happen, but it's a possibility. But anyway, as I said, Calipari, he shot down the rumors. And look, to be abundantly clear, no, I do not believe that he is going to be leaving college basketball anytime soon, and certainly not this offseason. But if he has another bad year, does he try to leave? Do Kentucky fans and Kentucky's administration maybe say, hey, maybe you should look at that Toronto Raptors job. Maybe you should look at that Indiana Pacers job. And then on the flip side, with the name, image, likeness stuff, I am just curious to see what happens. But at the end of the day, Calipari is going to be here this year. And let's be honest, I believe he is going to be at Kentucky for a very, very long time.